You're listening to Greater Good Radio Hawaii. Today's guest is Terrence George, Vice President and Executive Director of the Harold K.L. Castle Foundation. He also serves on the board of the Entrepreneur Foundation of Hawaii and the National Kidney Foundation of Hawaii. Please visit us online at greatergoodradio.com.
So before we talk about the Castle Foundation, can you maybe go into a little bit about how you developed that perspective of going and doing something that you're passionate about and making your life as opposed to making your career and then making your life?
Well, one of my long-held beliefs is that, you know, we have an opportunity to give back to the rest of the world what we don't have. And I think we actually have a duty to help each other and help those who are less fortunate than we are. And I think I found that in my own faith. I grew up in the Congregational Church, and there was a lot of talk about how we can help those who are less fortunate. And you know what? It feels good when you're helping somebody else. And so I wanted to feel good more. Maybe it's an endorphin incentive to do good. And I think that's part of what inspires all of us. You feel connected when you do something that's meaningful and that makes a difference, especially when you can do it in a way that you're not giving a handout to someone, but you're actually giving a hand up, and you end up really learning as much from those you're helping as the other way around. I also think, Evan, that the era when I was at Stanford was really useful. It was the middle of the 70s. Vietnam War we just left Vietnam. There had been a history protest there and at Berkeley. So there's still a fair amount of social awareness. But what was really cool was I was in the middle of Silicon Valley. And it was just this hotbed of people starting companies all over the place. And you know what? It infected the university, and it infected the nonprofit organizations around. So virtually everybody had half a dozen ideas that they were trying out, and they were fine just hanging out there and being willing to fail. And that allowed me to think of my own vocational work to serve others in an entrepreneurial way.
What do you suggest for people out there that are trying to figure out a way to help others and earn a decent living and a decent lifestyle and support their family here in Hawaii, where, you know, it's extremely expensive to live?
It really is. I think people need to focus on family first. There's no question, because if you've got what you need to make your family strong, then and only then do you have enough in yourself to give to others. But it doesn't cost very much, either in time or money, to do something that's meaningful for others. I know great people who volunteer 1 hour a week tutoring at Pololo School. And that 1 hour a week is so meaningful for the kids who are tutored, because they get sort of a supportive adult in their life. And that's one of the things that we've learned in the education field, and I'm involved in that in the Harold Castle Foundation and our youth opportunities work. Basically, when young people have one caring adult in their life, that's all they need to develop a sense of hope and a sense of self-esteem. So you know what? You can spend 1 hour a week and do it a heck of a lot. And the range of volunteer opportunities is huge. Those who are interested in finding out more about how to do that can just talk to friends. Many of the top business leaders in Hawaii are tremendous volunteers, and somehow they've been able to juggle family and a stupendous career and community service. And I think it'd be worth people out there to talk to their bosses and say, how do you do it? Find a mentor, find a model, and try stuff out.
So the Harold K.L. Castle Foundation, are you able to tell us about your involvement with that?
Sure. This foundation was started in 1962 by Harold K.L. Castle, the owner of Kaneohe Ranch and developer of much of Kaneohe and Kailua. And he basically initially granted land to the foundation, and the income from that land was used to make grants. And the first grants were like $500 to the YMCA and $500 here and there. But as the income from the land grew and fees were purchased by owners of the homes and the developments that he had created in Kaneohe and Kailua, the foundation really developed a set of resources that were beyond probably Harold Castle's wildest imaginations. This allows us now to invest around $7 million a year in the community in the making of grants. One thing that's really important, folks think, oh, you know, giving away money, that must be really easy and really fun. It's really fun, but it's not easy at all when your job is not to make grants and just write a check to a nonprofit, but your job is to really make Hawaii a fundamentally better place. And it's already a great place. But a couple of the areas that we're focusing on now are public education redesign, so that every kid, no matter where they live in Hawaii, no matter what their family and community is like, has the opportunity for a great education. The second is bringing back our fish. in our nearshore marine coral ecosystem areas, because we've had major drops of fish prevalence. We've had problems in the coral reefs. And if we want Hawaii to be the way it used to be, then we need to learn how to manage those resources the way they were managed very, very well 200 years ago. And then the third area of focus is giving back to Windward Oahu from Kahuku to Waimanalo. And that's a lot of fun. We're able to fund a wide range of initiatives. We have a small staff, so we keep our administrative costs low, and we have to say no to a lot of great things, but we get to say yes to stuff, and we get to be deal makers. And I just wanted to link our work with the work in the business world. It's not that different. You make deals, you find partnerships, you spot opportunities. One of the things that's not so well done by many nonprofits is the area of marketing and being more customer focused. So we get to serve as sort of management consultants. And where we sit, we get to see the broad horizon of work that's being done in a particular field. So sometimes, say, if Carrie, if you're doing some great work in one school and Evan, you're doing great work in another, I try to get you two together to talk. Because when you get dedicated people together, then there's that synergy effect. And I know we see that in business, too.